Hey, what's up guys, I'm Sammy, and two of the biggest smartphones this year are the Galaxy S8 and OnePlus 5. So in this video, we're gonna see which phone is actually better, and more importantly, if OnePlus is still a flagship killer. The Galaxy S8 is priced at around $700 to $800, and the OnePlus 5 is at almost $500. The price jump there is actually quite large, but the feature sets aren't too different, so this is gonna be super interesting. I've also made a full review on the Galaxy S8 with the OnePlus 5 review coming soon as well, so don't miss out on that, make sure to subscribe. So kicking things off with performance, it already gets super crazy here because the OnePlus 5 features the newest Snapdragon 835, and so does the Galaxy S8, but in some areas it also comes with the Exynos 8895, which is slightly faster than the Snapdragon 835. The S8 has 4GB of RAM, whereas the OnePlus 5 comes with either 6 or 8, so just in terms of pure hardware, OnePlus is already sort of leading the way here. It's got almost the same processor, but slightly more RAM, and an operating system which is much closer to stock Android. That means it's going to run faster than the Galaxy S8 in your daily usage, and when you're doing heavy multitasking, that extra RAM is going to kick in and be super helpful with your pace. Tied in with speed, the fingerprint scanner is also faster on the OnePlus 5, literally being faster than the speed at which you blink, so it's quite impressive how fast they've made it. The S8 is still really fast compared to the OnePlus 5, and honestly in daily usage it won't be too noticeable, but it will perform a little bit worse. For example, the fingerprint scanner is significantly slower than the OnePlus 5, and just doing regular multitasking, the animations that TouchWiz has will slow you down. And tied into specs, the OnePlus 5 also has a larger battery life, which is going to last you comfortably for a whole day of usage, whereas the S8 does start getting close to running empty by the end of a day of heavy usage. Regardless, I'd recommend that you buy a portable battery pack anyway, link in the description to one that I use, but if that's not an option, the OnePlus 5 might be slightly more reliable. Charging speeds are also quite different here because OnePlus has included their signature dash charging technology, which makes the OnePlus 5 charge very fast compared to the S8, especially when you're actually using the phone while it charges. That could be a major plus for some of you because it means you can get up to a full day's of charge quicker, and it's going to last you longer on the OnePlus 5. Moving on to the cameras, the Galaxy S8 has been leading the way as far as camera quality goes, and that's mostly still the same case even up against the OnePlus 5. While it does feature two cameras to give you lots of extra flexibility and options, images are inconsistent in terms of how good they look, especially when doing things like blurring the background. That means if you're in the moment and you need to take a shot of something important, your OnePlus 5 could mess it up and you'll end up with a below average shot, which is incredibly annoying. That's simply because OnePlus just doesn't have the tech that Samsung has to make their smartphone as reliable, and as such, the S8 performs more consistently well and actually produces higher quality images in some cases. For the most part though, both smartphones have quite good cameras, and the differences won't be too easy to notice unless the OnePlus 5 does mess up by oversaturating or blurring a subject, which has been known to happen. So for the displays, it gets really interesting here because the Galaxy S8 has the beautiful Infinity Edge display running at Quad HD, which makes consuming content and just using the phone in general a great experience. It's really immersive because they've pretty much completely cut the bezels off, so it's definitely got the superior screen. The OnePlus 5 is still running at 1080p in 2017 as well, which is a huge letdown for some people. Both displays will work fairly well though, but it's going to be quite obvious how much better the S8 is, especially if you put them side by side. For those of you who have the OnePlus 3T, you know exactly what I mean because the OnePlus 5 has a nearly identical display. And once again, in terms of design, the S8 leads the way here because it feels really good in the hands, and with that all glass design, it does look really good. In terms of the OnePlus 5's looks, it does come down to what you prefer, but since it does kind of rip off the iPhone 7 Plus's design, lots of people aren't happy with that. Personally, I don't think that's a big deal because I think the iPhone 7 Plus design is really good. Of course, it would have been better for something unique, but I do feel that both still look great. Because of that Infinity Edge design though, I am gonna have to say that the S8 probably wins the battle as far as design goes. In terms of extra features, the Galaxy S8 has a lot of them. For example, waterproofing and the iris scanner, just to name a few, which are both huge benefits that the OnePlus just doesn't have. In my opinion, that puts the S8 far ahead because they've included a lot of interesting new tech, which is actually quite useful, and OnePlus hasn't been able to do that. For example, the headphones included in the S8 box are also really good, and that's just a small touch which people never really talk about, but I think it shouldn't go unnoticed. You're getting a very premium product if you buy the Galaxy S8. The OnePlus 5 is still just a relatively safe choice in terms of offering vanilla features but doing it really well and overall working very well. As for which one you should buy, it does depend on your budget. If you look at what both phones offer and then consider if the extra $200 or so makes it worth the jump to the S8, then definitely go for it. If not, bear in mind that in a lot of ways you're still getting a better smartphone than the S8 for less money if you choose the OnePlus 5, which definitely makes it really appealing. Personally, the choice for me is quite difficult, and I'm just going to use them both in my daily life anyway. That's what I usually do with my two favorite smartphones, and it's probably what I'll settle for here. If I really did have to choose one though, I would probably choose the OnePlus, just because they're charging a lower price, which I think is really cool, and we should have more companies doing that. But guys, with that, I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, make sure you hit that like button, check out these two videos on the screen as well if you haven't seen them, make sure to subscribe if you're new around here, and I'm out. Peace.